Hey Andy, I thought I'd do a quick video response. Well, what an oxymoron coming from me, quick video response about this communication thing, because it's interesting that you're talking about that. I think of it in terms of project management from what I do. So I think in terms of communication channels, you know, and you have got that model of, let's say you've got four people that are talking. In a project, you actually have six communication channels, and that number rises exponentially. Let's say you have 10 people in a project. Now you're going to have 45 different communication channels. So just thinking about the communication channels themselves, you begin to realize how many ways people communicate. Now, the real key is not so much understanding that all this communication is going on, is finding the right communication that works for a particular team. I've had, and I usually have to do this when I start a project, I usually have to find out how does the team want to communicate, how do they normally communicate, what communication tools do they use, what do they prefer. Now in a corporate setting, most everyone has email. Most everyone has voicemail. Nowadays, I'm seeing more and more companies deploy IM, instant messages, locally within the organization. So I've got supervisors, senior managers, tech team leaders, tech team members, all kinds of folks. Some prefer instant messaging. Just IM me. Just ask me the question. And I'll respond right away. Some like voicemail. Leave me a voicemail. I'll get back to you eventually. Some don't want to be IM'd. If you IM them, you can't even find them on IM because they don't fire it up in the first place. And if they are on, they won't answer you that way. Leave them a voicemail. Other people are send me an email. I'll respond to you in an email. Or no, don't send me an email unless it's really, really important. Because if it's not really important, I'm not going to get to it anytime soon. Leave me a voicemail. Then there are those that prefer pick your lazy butt up off your chair, walk down the hall, and talk to me face to face. And I know many managers, supervisors, and team leaders that would rather communicate that way. So when you're looking at this picture, with these models of different communications, at least in terms of the numbers, you can start spinning these in a 3, 4, 5, 6 dimensional way, in the sense of throw in social media. What happens if we start to communicate with social media? It's another form of IM. It's another form of communication. The biggest problem that you run into with most large companies, particularly in my line of work with pharmaceutical companies, is the information that they that's in a project, they do not want that information public. That information has to be controlled in a very, very structured way. So it is unlikely that you will be able to use social media in that type of an environment. In another environment, you might be able to set up a private hub, for example, of Twitter users that could communicate back and forth within a company or on a project, or perhaps a Facebook group that is invite only, and that group is actually your project team who's actually working on the team. So there's a lot of different ways you can do it. You just have to think about a couple of different things to begin with. The communication model and the number of people that are going to be communicating. Communication styles. A lot of people don't like certain ways of communication, and you're going to find some people don't like social media at all. So they may not be comfortable communicating that way at all in a project sense. You have to look at the sensitivity of the information that is being communicated and confidentiality, not only from a company perspective or a regulatory perspective, but perhaps even from a financial perspective or a user privacy perspective, medical data, financial data, all of those things that you have to protect on behalf of someone else, because that information really needs to be protected. So when you start thinking about these different communication models, even though you and I look at it and say, you know, Twitter, Facebook, something would really help with this communication, there's lots of different ways to communicate. There's lots of information that has to be communicated, and you have to control what gets communicated to whom when. And people have different expectations and different likes and dislikes when it comes to communication. So you have to think about all of these things when you're trying to devise the best communication plan for a project or your organization or what you're doing, because you have to think about all of these different communication aspects and bring together a model that works for everybody. And it can be challenging at times, but it's a great topic. So let's keep talking about it.